Okay, take one. 3, 2, 1.
Yo, yo, this is the Uso Table Talk Podcast.
Salo for lover, kia ora, malo lele, aloha, bulivinaka, whakalo falahi atu, kia ora na.
And what's good,
everybody? You're tuned in here live and direct with your boy, DJ Waves, Nons, Frosty, and Rolly. And we are back with back. Another episode of the Uso Table Talk Podcast.
Let's go.
Let's go. A huge shout out to the Hills Video and Podcast Studio for letting us use their space, man. Forever grateful,
shout
bro.
Out, shout
forever,
out.
Shout out. Forever grateful.
Thank you. Big love to you guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. We appreciate the love and support from everybody. Man, you guys have been blessing us, and we hope that everything that we do bless you guys as well. So thank you for staying patient, man.
This season
is definitely a long
loyal,
time
man.
Coming.
Loyal.
We appreciate that.
But we're so grateful, and once again, we appreciate every single one of you guys.
Yeah.
But man, what have we been up to? What have we been doing, boys?
All right, chilling, eh?
We pretty much explained it on episode one, but still been a hectic year for us. Like everyone's just doing their own thing. You get me?
Oh.
I'm part British now, so.
Is that British or is that Jamaica?
So if you guys need any voiceovers for the British people, you can get the shout out to you guys, man.
Bro.
Shione Toki.
Nah. Yeah, but that's us.
How are you, Frosty?
Yeah, good, man. Very good.
Yeah.
Alive, you know, alive and kicking. And
that's the one, bro.
You know, God is good all the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Let's go.
Ilelele to.
Tell me my love. 100%.
Come on now.
Yes.
Shout it.
You good?
Yeah, bro. Been well, man. Been well. Working, youth, church, footy.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's been good. But it's good to be back, bro. I feel like it's always a huge gap before we see each other again.
Hard up.
Yeah, man. But it's good to be back, bro. It's good to be back.
Definitely.
Good to be back. How about you, Mia? What you been up to us?
Bro, I've been busy, bro? Man.
Yeah.
Last week, I hit a record of 3 gigs in 1 weekend.
Wow.
Yeah, man. I'm pretty proud of myself.
And that was all after the Lele interview, right?
Yeah.
Wow. No, it was Lele was in between.
In between, yeah. So it was
the
like
three
a birthday, gigs. The podcast.
Oh, jeez.
And then I finished off with the church opening.
Clap it up.
Thank Come on. You. Thank wow. you.
That's right. The church gig.
That's hard out here. That's OTG, bro. On the go.
Wow.
It was actually good. It was actually good to play at the church because I felt like it was taking me right back to my youth days when I was... Where I started, so it's good.
It always starts, eh? It always starts at the youth. You trying to pick a song.
Shout out to youth.
Shout out to the youth too.
Oh man.
Yeah, if you don't know, Waves was playing at a opener. It was a local church. What area?
I can't remember. I think it's towards Mascot.
Yeah, towards Mascot.
Wow, that's far.
Yeah. They had their own open up their own building.
Yeah, man.
You know, oh wow, well done to that church. Awesome. Beautiful. You love to see it.
Was good. Yeah.
Come on, love seeing.
I thought right now we'll get into a quick game. I know we love games, but this is a good one. I put some questions down for a music game. So I know a lot of us are a bit good when it comes to music.
I'm really good at it.
I dabble.
I got to encourage you though. These questions are a bit of everything, you know?
Everything, right.
So it's got a bit of local, got a bit of... overseas, like it's just not so local.
Yeah,
bit of our people and a bit of old school.
Oh,
so it's a little bit of you guys.
I love
you know?
The variety.
The variety.
I love the variety. Bluetooth device.
What?
What? If you know, you would know.
The Bluetooth device.
The Bluetooth.
The Bluetooth. The Bluetooth device is connected. It's like a fast fella.
Bro, I love the diversity, bro, going on there. I like it.
All right, let's go. So basically,
what's our buzzers? Our name?
You guys are gonna work together.
Oh.
So.
Hey.
All right. It's team effort. All right, guys. You know?
All right.
So then there's only Jake one
Smith.
Winner.
Jake Smith.
Ben.
Over.
So basically, there's 10 questions you have to get through.
Yeah.
And these are 10 questions that could be like, don't think too far out and don't think too small.
We're ready.
Right. Okay. So these are 10 questions that you just have to knock out in 90 seconds. Are we cool?
90 seconds.
All of them.
10 questions.
What?
10 questions.
In 90 seconds?
Yeah.
Hold on.
Are you mad?
I'll read it very fast.
That's not even one question.
Folding already to the challenge?
Gee.
Come on.
All right, let's go.
Let's do it.
Give it a try.
When you get older,
if you can't get it, just say pass and we'll go back to it.
All right, let's go.
No, you just
if you have the time.
Let's go. Come on.
All right, let's go.
All right, ready?
Yeah.
T-minus 90 seconds.
Passing away in 2009, which pop artist released the hit song Don't Stop Till You Get Enough and Rock With You?
Michael Jackson.
Formed in 1970, which band released the songs Another One Bites the Dust and Queen. I Want to Break Free?
Ooh.
Oh, wow, the wrong song. The Australian rap group HB Boys consists of three members, HB Onnit, HB Wise, and who?
M-Ways.
Well done.
Released in 2021, which artist did Bruno Mars recently collab with on Anderson the song?
Anderson Paak.
Come on.
Formed in 1964, which band released the hit songs Get Down On It and Celebration?
Cool in the Gang.
I don't know.
Oh!
Come on.
What singer played the lead role as Justice in the 1993 movie Poetic Justice?
Tupac.
What's her
name? Janet Jackson.
Okay, well done.
In 2004, which Polynesian duo debuted their first album, Always and For Real?
Adiz.
Ooh.
Yeah.
In 1998, Brandy released a song called Sitting Up In My What?
Room.
Nice. Which New Zealand band released the songs In The Air, Y.O.Y.?
Lab.
Yes.
Yeah.
Which US rapper released the album 2014, Forest Hill Drive?
J. Cole.
Let's go.
That was you boys.
That was us, man.
That was us. Unity.
Wow.
Yeah, bro.
Wow.
Yeah, bro.
Don't test me.
Don't test me, bro.
Levels, yeah?
You get me, man.
It's land, fam. Let's go.
That was good.
Our contribution, regardless of how big or small, is the contribution nonetheless.
Did we actually do that in 90 seconds?
Bro, how much time
do we have left?
I think he's had about 10 seconds left.
Wow. To spare. Chuck in 5 more questions, bro.
Next episode.
next time. More preparation. Don't ever do it spontaneously.
That was good.
That was actually really good.
Surprising.
Those are some good questions.
That's some good questions, Us.
Yeah, well done. Thanks,
man. Very well presented. Well,
cheers.
It's very good.
A plus, man.
Mad, awesome.
Right now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to get to our next segment, which is What's the Jam?
The Usaw Table Talk Podcast. Hold up a second. What's the Jam?
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, family. This segment is the What's the Jam, and if you don't know what's the Jam is, this is a time that we set aside to plug and to put forward local businesses or local poly people that are doing it big, no matter if it's our local or local around the world. We just want to show love. It can be maybe business owners, it can be a Instagram page or social media page or organization, whatever it is.
Yeah.
We love our people and we just want to put it out there. Yeah. So today's What's the Jam
that
I want to plug is called the Big Big Aloha.
Woo!
Hawaiian Grinds Hawaiian Food Truck. And I would just want to give a massive shout out to Marcus and Lilika Joseph.
Okay.
Let's go.
Or in Hawaiian, your sepa. Shout out to you guys. So a little bit about Marcus and his journey.
Yeah.
So Marcus is Aotearoa born, but Mount Drua raised. So he moved to Maunie when he was about 3 years old, infant. And so he's Māori, and so Aotearoa born, Mount Drua raised. He served his mission, so he's from the LDS Church, and he served mission in Nicaragua.
What? Where is that? Wow.
Nicaragua.
Wow.
Yeah, I just like the saying, Nicaragua.
Is that in Madagascar? That is it?
No, I don't know,
it's
bro.
It's in Africa, bro.
Sorry, so if you know where Nicaragua is,
Comment down below and let us know.
That could sound like a Fijian place.
No, no, it's not. It's a Spanish-speaking country. It's a Spanish-speaking country. Okay, which leads me to his next attribute. He speaks fluent Spanish that he learned on his mission, which then allowed him to work as a Spanish translator at the PCC Polynesian Cultural Center in Hawaii. So now we're piecing it together. Yeah. So Marcus attended BYU in Hawaii, where he met his wife Lilika from Tonga, but she's half Tongan and half Canadian. I never met a half Tongan, half Canadian.
Bro, that's mad.
Yeah, anyway, but they met in Hawaii at BYU. And so anyway, they moved back to Australia.
Yeah.
Where Marcus worked as a travel agent in Mount Druitt. And so, and the travel agency saw heaps of business, and Marcus thought, you know what? Why not? Why can't I do something like this? Why can't I start my own? So Marcus started his own travel agency.
Wow.
So he killed it. They were killing it. They were seeing heaps of business come through.
Oh, that's awesome.
And then COVID hit. COVID. COVID-19.
I hate you, man.
Anyway, so COVID-19 hits, and that's where he came up. So the business, obviously, travel agency. No one traveled out of Australia.
Yeah.
So the travel agent, you know, they had to put it to rest for a bit, and where they birthed the Big Big Aloha. It is a Hawaiian food truck where they have local Hawaiian grinds, you know, food. They have local foods. From Hawaii. So they got the Hawaiian barbecue mix plate. They got the katsu. They got the musubis. They got the poke. They got the salmon poke. They got the spicy ahi. And I'm talking about legit poke. Not none of this they sell at North Sydney. They call it poke, but it's chicken. Ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you something. Poke, Cook Island poke is a sweet dish, but Hawaiian poke is not chicken. It is not chicken on top of beans and salads and that. Poke is fish, raw fish diced on top of some, you know, some rice. It can be brown rice, it can be white rice, but it's tuna or salmon. You know, that's poke, real poke from Hawaii.
Mm.
So,
I don't know, bro.
Yeah, anyway, so. That was the, so they opened up this truck, and honestly, it is probably one of the closest things, closest foods that I've seen that matches food in Hawaii.
Yeah.
Or local foods.
That's big.
You guys remember my wedding
when we went to Hawaii?
Not really. but you guys remember? I went there specifically for the spicy ahi. Bro, it is very good and very close to Hawaii standards.
Come on.
Yeah, so shout out to you guys. So they started off in gazebos, doing weekend stuff and festivals, waitangi days.
That's right.
Things like that. So they started off in those, and then now they have their food truck. And I asked him if he had any advice for people out there that either wanted to start something or just for our people out there.
That's good.
He said that the best advice that he ever got was from one of his mentors from his church, and an uncle of his. And the advice is, put God first, work as hard as you can, find your oil, which means find what you're good at, and make your mark. And then he lives by this motto, is that life isn't about how happy you are, it's about how happy others are because of you. All right? And there's something else I want to add to this. As hardworking as he is, now this is kind of sad, but the man is a trooper. The reason why he moved back to Australia is because he was diagnosed with leukemia. So the man takes he's on chemo. Sorry. So he takes his chemo every single day.
Wow.
But then he's out there at the truck, and he's working during the week, providing for his family. Geez. He's putting it down. Man. Bro, and he's got massive plans for the future. This man is not letting anything stop him.
Come on, bro.
So a man that lives like that and chases his dreams and wants to provide for his family and not settle for the mediocre while dealing with that,
you know, how many storms have I been through and I'm like, man, that's like, I can't do it.
Tapping
you
out.
Know? This guy doesn't let anything stop him. So I want to make a massive shout out to the big, big Aloha, Hawaiian Grinds, Marcus and Liquor, the Yosepa awesome. Family, the Joseph family. Shout out to you guys. Doing big things.
Big love, big love.
Wow.
Mad love.
Man, thank you so much, Frosty. Bro, yeah. That was a jam.
Yeah, man.
100%.
Yeah, make sure you stay tuned for the Instagram that will drop. On our Instagram, sorry.
I have a quick question. Whereabouts do they run now?
Sorry, brother. Yes. So they're currently at Park Lee Markets. You can find them at Park Lee Markets.
Wow, we're not far from there.
Not far from there. Very local. Also, they also started things like, do you guys know what Fijoa is?
Oh, Fijoas, yes.
Fijoas. Okay, yes. So what's the only Kiwi.
Oh.
We're not Kiwis, so we don't know.
I have no clue what the heck that is.
What is it? It's a fruit. Okay, anyway, so they started like Fijoa.
Yeah.
Fijoa ice creams.
What?
But you gotta get in quick because I went there one day and they had all their plates were sold out.
Wow.
Yeah, right? So you need to get there quick. So it's at Park Lee Markets. Look them up. I believe it's door 3. Correct me if I'm wrong. But anyway, also, they're going to open up more trucks, you know.
Yes,
awesome.
Go.
So all the best for the future.
Yeah, man.
Sicky, man.
Wowzers.
Damn.
Wow.
That's a what's the jam, bro.
The big, big aloha.
Big, big aloha. Big, big aloha.
Definitely going to remember that one.
So nice you got to say it twice, bro.
big.
True.
Big,
big.
Big love to the big, big aloha and the rest of the team. Thank you so much. We hope you, for all those who are watching, we hope you can go check it out at the Park Lee Markets.
Yeah.
Make sure you show some love, fam.
Yeah.
But other than that, right now we're going to get into our next segment, which is Hot Tala.
Hey.
The Usaw Table Talk Podcast.
Hot Tala. That's Hot Tala for you, bro. All right, Hot Tala. Basically, this is a segment. If this is your first time, this is a segment where we get real. We keep it 100 and we really share our hearts and pretty much bring it to the table. So there's a lot of conversations and topics that we cover. But obviously, we want to first and foremost, say that we're not professionals at what we do. We're just usos that grabbed the mic and got it on video and putting our hearts on the table, man.
Yeah.
And if anything, like for us, obviously we have a biblical background with us being boys that obviously met in Bible college and have experiences from a college that we attended. So a lot of our experiences definitely come from those kind of backgrounds. And we hope that whatever we speak and whatever you guys receive today may encourage you and may it speak life into wherever you guys are at.
Beautiful.
Yeah, so it's my turn for Hot Tala.
Come on.
And I'm really excited. I got around this idea, and me and Nons were having a conversation about how sometimes, like, in our upbringings, we weren't really the best at receiving advice.
Right.
You know, for me personally, I never really had a father as I grew up. So for me, it was more so, I felt like I was constantly grabbing advice from wherever I could, if anything, it was like I had to build my own understanding of how to discern advice. So discerning is pretty much like comparing, or if anything, going through and sifting through what's good for you.
Yeah,
you know, and that's pretty much what we mean. So the title I wanted to title this Hot Tala is discerning advice. So I'm bringing that to the table and it's gonna get hot.
Let's do it.
We're gonna do it. But the first question I wanted to bring up is obviously, like I shared with my experiences, in your upbringing, what were you like receiving life advice? Were you either a rebel or, you know, straighty 180? If you don't know what that means, it's basically someone who was so good, a whole life is perfect and listen to everyone.
I know you should be like that.
But basically that's what I want to bring up and I want to, you know, let's get a bit vulnerable, let's get a bit real. So feel free to jump in, boys. Let's go.
Yeah,
you go.
All right. I was terrible at taking advice. Anyone give me advice, I'll do the opposite. I think that's for them, that's not for me. Which I think sometimes isn't that bad to discern it, but for me, it was just rejecting everything because I knew my own way.
Mm. Yeah.
It wasn't until I got older that everything started to make sense, or going through certain situations that I was like, ah, that's what my parents were meaning, or that's what my brother meant, or this person meant.
Yeah.
Right. So advice when I was a youth and as a kid was, I didn't really take it in.
Yeah.
I just heard it and was like, okay, whatever. But it wasn't until that I went through certain situations and also grew older that I knew, okay, so that's what it was. So I learned the hard way. Mm. And I'm still learning, but yeah, so.
Yeah, that's good, man. Nice,
bro. I feel like I was the opposite of that when I was growing up. Like, when I was growing up, like, I'm not trying to bag out my parents or anything, but I was in that, like, kind of like the strict category, kind of.
Yeah.
It was always like, I think it's because I didn't know anything more. Like, I didn't know how to rebel. Like, I didn't really have that experience, like, seeing people do that.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. And it was just like, oh, this is what I should do, so I'll stick to it. So going to school, bro, I think I only jigged school like once.
Wow.
No, honest, bro, like, I couldn't, like,
bro, it was just that's that. Good.
Good man.
It was good, and then, but then eventually when I grew up, obviously, I wanted to experiment some stuff,
Yeah,
you know, I'm old enough. Well, at that time, I believed I was old enough.
Yeah, right.
And I got to that. Like, even I read it here. I even mentioned in on my notes here that, like, we had a trip away for our footy team.
Yeah.
So we won the grand final. This is 2012.
Oh.
We're in the grand final, and then we had a massive trip away after that.
Yeah.
We went to Jamboree or something.
Shout out to Jamboree.
So we all went, and like the boys are all like on it. They're all drinking this, that. Yeah. And then I was the little angel in the room, just like, just watching everyone just laughing and just making sure that they're all right.
Yeah.
You know, and like there were so many times where they could just encourage me to drink or do what they're doing and following them, and I was like, oh nah, it's all good, I'm alright. And that was just like my mentality, and that was, I think it was just because like I wanted to listen to like the good stuff, the advice that I got from my parents, and I think I was just surrounded by good people, like good voices.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And and then I started growing, and then I started to believe that I was growing up, and then I started to rebel, like, yeah, just straight out. Like, I was like, oh, maybe I should try this out, you know? Like, people say it's good, so why not?
Yeah, yeah.
And then, complete opposite to yourself, but, bro, like, best outcome at the end.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying, man?
You know what you're saying, bro. No, Zolly, I was 100% similar to you, bro. Yeah, bro. Very similar to you, bro.
The lockdown boys, eh?
So I've been locked down, bro.
What's COVID? What is COVID?
Still in lockdown. Nah, yeah, bro. So, bro, mine's heaps similar to you, Adels.
Yeah, bro.
I wasn't perfect, but growing up, I was a kid who would just take it in.
Yeah, yeah.
And like not say anything and then just wear it. And then same as you, Nons, I don't think I ever sort of like rebelled when I was younger because I didn't know any other way.
True.
And so I was just constantly listening to advice from parents, and like I was super tight with my mom, super tight with my grandparents, so like my support system was heaps close knit around me, and so I didn't know anything else. And then, like, even growing up, like, I can't say that I went out much. But I think growing up, I maybe experienced a little bit more. And growing up, I sort of wanted to maybe push the boundaries a little bit and maybe, like, just experience life. But for the most part, man, I've taken advice. And I think for me, it depends who it's from. And the relationship I have with the person who's giving the advice.
100%.
And so, I think, man. Like, for the most part, it's always been people that I deem close that I would take advice from.
But
if you're just someone I've just met and you try and give me advice, I'm like I'll be polite about it, but it just comes one ear and goes up the other.
True.
That's good.
I think like, well, yeah, I totally agree with what you're saying. And I think for me, the one thing I think from my perspective or my experience was, you know that saying, live and learn?
Yeah.
I think for me it was live and then I learned. It's so true, because like there was so many times I would have like uncles and my family and everyone drinking up at home and I just remember my home life was like constantly being reminded that I didn't want to do that, I shouldn't, you know, do what or copy what they were doing. But little did they know, 14 years old, I was my first drink. And it was
take that back.
Like I would say I was pretty rebellious in my early teens, and right. I think that's where a lot of my living and then learning started for me.
Started, right.
Like my mom would always advise certain things for me not to do, but I rebelled so much to a point where I just had no ear for anything but whatever I wanted to do, pretty much. And I wanted to get into the question, because you were answering it. The next question is, in your experience, how have you learned which voices are the right ones to allow to speak into your life? And I think like what you touched on was pretty cool with how you have certain people that you listen to,
right?
And I think I'll start off. One of the craziest things that I've always allowed myself to be something that I will like, a kind of like a past that I'll let myself listen to you.
Yeah,
is loyalty.
Yeah,
and if anything, like, it doesn't matter who you are or what background you come from. I genuinely listen more to people who are loyal to me, in a way of like, okay, I received that advice, because not only do you want to speak good into my life, but you also live my life with me. You know what I mean? And that's why I think like it's such a good thing that I have like you boys and also other souls that speak in, that I allow speak into my life. And like I've seen myself like taking that live and learn process, live and then learn process, like so much more better.
Right.
So it's like, I'm seeing myself grow with the advice that people who are loyal to me. And one thing I wanted to share a quick example was, you know, Gary Vee?
Yeah.
He's a like motivational speaker.
Oh, yes.
And this is the craziest thing.
I know.
This is the craziest thing. This guy goes out, like he shares these little videos, you know, and some people, they come up to him with like, oh, I had this business idea that I wanted to share. Wanted to start, but I just don't know what to do. And then he just says to them, just do it.
Yeah.
And then they're like, oh my God, that was the best advice I ever got.
Yes.
I was like, gee, Gary Vee doesn't even know you, bro. And you got people who are so loyal to you, telling you, just do it.
Right.
And it's like, should I?
Yeah.
What the heck, bro? Yeah, and I think that's something I want to encourage people. Like there's some people who are so loyal to us and, you know, who genuinely want to see us, but they're speaking words of life, but we're not having it. And I think that's something I've learned, even with listening to my mom now more and even my family. I'm like, man, I'm having it now. You know, I'm definitely taking those in. Right. I don't know. That's like, what do you guys
think? I think like going off of that, this is a little bit off topic, but it's the same thing.
Yeah.
I was watching one day, it's a Polynesian guy, and he leads this like healing seminars, right?
Oh.
Where a lot of these people will come and he's got all these feathers out and he puts it over them.
Wow.
Right, like whatever, each to their own, 100%. Yeah. But predominantly the the crowd is non-Polynesians.
Oh, okay.
Non-people of color. Caucasians, right?
White people.
And they were like searching for like it looked like they were just, oh my gosh, he knows everything. Like this guy. And he just seemed like just some normal guy from the area. they just thought, you know what, I'm gonna start like making these noises and chink, chink, like not holding the these uncle. Like sound things or whatever. Look, I'm not knocking it, but what I'm saying is that I feel like there's so many people out there that are searching for a prophet in somebody. Like someone that I don't know, or someone that is like, you know, on a pedestal, needs to tell me my next step, you know? I'm laughing at that because I see that all the time. The people next to you that know you, that love you, are like, hey man, you're like,
and look, doing life with you,
know, doing 100%. Life with you, it's like, oh, you're really good at this, you should do this. And it's just like, I don't know. And it's not until some like, mystical kind of being shows up and says, like, and honestly, I've been that guy sometimes, like, that my closest friends have told me things, and I'm like, oh, I don't know. And like, I was waiting for some, like, some wizard to just walk out of walk out of the bush one day and be like, hey, you need to do this. And I'm like, oh my gosh, you're right. But maybe my parents were telling you that, or maybe my usos were telling you that. I reckon that is so true, man. But that's what I put it down to in my head. I was thinking, everyone wants a prophet. Like, everyone's trying to look for some sort of, like, lead me. Lead me.
I've seen a post similar to that.
Oh, yeah.
And it was like saying, like, oh, people like to, like, buy all these nice, expensive things.
Yeah.
And like full shout out all these big names and stuff.
But there's
people like in your own circle that they are won't like trying to pop off.
Yeah.
But it's like, bro, like that's such a real thing. Like there's so many locals and that's what we're trying to do.
Yeah.
Trying to make that circle or trying to make our circle, like trying to bring them out, pop them off, and then you know, hopefully they can get to the big bucks. But I read a fair bit here, but I feel like I was thinking of the perspective of when you get advice from a new voice.
Mm.
You know what I mean? So when a new voice comes to you, I feel like it's a game of trial and error. Maybe I will listen to him, maybe I won't. You know,
true.
And then but then at the end of the day, there's a fine line between advice and having. And listening to a biased opinion, you know what I mean. So so obviously there's gonna be people that will advise you and give you that guidance towards a better option. But then there's gonna be people that are gonna be trying to shove down an answer down your throat.
Yeah, true.
And just make you listen to that. But I feel like
that's why I don't. Genuinely, that's why I don't believe in fortune tellers. Because you're actually paying them, you know?
Paying them, yeah.
So, like, you're going to get your money's worth.
It's not a good gesture. It's not a good gesture. Yeah.
But, hey, fortune tellers, do your thing. Get your bag.
After pay.
It's all good.
Can I after pay you? And you give me this premonition or prediction.
And then that's when you cancel your after. Don't cancel it. You have to pay it off, guys.
Can I just rephrase? Hold on, the question. In your experience, how have you learned which voices are the right ones for you to allow to speak into you?
Yeah.
Can I?
Yeah.
I think with that, one is doing the journey with me.
Yeah.
100% is that if I know you and I know, but also sometimes the closest people that you know are like, are not giving you the best advice.
Yeah. Oh, 100%. And they can be still loyal though.
Yeah. But I watch people as well. Like I'll just watch them how they analyze them, you know, and like how they live their lives and stuff. Because I'm very cautious with who I get advice from.
Yeah.
Even some of the closest people to me, I'm like, sometimes I'm looking and it's like, I'm not too sure when they try to give me advice. Like, for instance, there's a random couple that will be nameless right now. That I used to know. I still know. I still talk to them every now and then. But they were like, you know, you really need to be around us to learn what a healthy marriage is and whatnot and this and that.
Did they say you need?
Yeah. Right. So I was like, okay, yeah, whatever. You know,
it could be good.
Yeah, you know, it could be good. Until they started like yelling at each other in front of me. And I was like, "Hey, shut up." And I was like, oh.
Not the debating. Not the healthy debate.
But you can always flip things, you know. And, right. and I learn things from people. Sometimes it's, oh, that's great. I'm going to take that advice. Yeah, yeah. And take that. Also, when I see something weird, I'm like, okay, I'm not going to do that.
Not going to take that part.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. yeah. So yeah. In essence, you learn anyway.
Yeah,
like, true. Okay, that's something I'm going to do. Or no, that's something I'm going to make sure that I'm not that way.
Yeah. You know? Mm. So it's like your own little mixed pot of advice. You're mm. taking yeah. bits and pieces oh, from yeah, bro. Your yeah, experiences, yeah. your life experience, those around you.
Yeah.
yeah. And even things you see. You
the
know.
Potluck advice.
Yeah. yeah. So like, also, nice. Yeah, also you go to kind of like, you know, if you know a mechanic and your car's broken, you go to him.
Mm.
You don't take your car to a chiropractor right. just because 100%. You know that chiropractor.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So yeah. that's the same thing yeah. out of my friends group. I got, you know, I know people that are really good with finances. So I'll go to them yeah. about finances.
Finance, yeah.
I know an older gentleman and him, he's got a strong marriage. He's yeah. a great father. I'll go to him about family advice.
Yeah.
You know, like some people barking up the wrong tree. You know, they're backing up a coconut tree and wanting strawberries. It's like, you got to assess.
Yeah. Number one.
100%.
Strawberries.
100%.
Who's who and what is the fruit they produce?
Yeah.
And go to them.
Yeah. Right.
I have yeah. one thing, like to, that's, I've heard that saying a lot though. Like, you can always judge a man by his fruits.
Yeah.
Or judge a man's yeah. words by his fruits. And this is something I think I've had trouble with, because sometimes the closest people who are bringing so much wisdom in my life,
mm.
don't have so many fruits
mm.
and don't have like the biggest fruits to show you.
Right.
I shouldn't have said that.
Yeah.
That was pretty.
No, anyway. It makes sense. But
does that make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah.
yeah. yeah.
yeah.
And I think it comes from their lack of fruit that they want to see in us. Yeah. They want to see our lives become fruitful.
Yeah.
Like, you look at our elders, and this is going into our next question. I'll ask after this, but like, some of our elders aren't the most richest people. But they want to see us excel in such a way where they want us to see to be able to be fruitful and, mm. and things like that. And I've always taken that saying about how, like, oh, you can always judge a man by his fruits and his word judge his words by his fruits and stuff like that. I think it's objective in a way, like, it doesn't always work like that.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
It's kind of, you know,
yeah.
More subjective to whatever whoever's talking to you at that time.
Right.
Yeah.
But I think
just quickly sorry. On that, but I think I also struggle with that as well.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
I think that's because, as society, we've been taught that fruit means plenty.
Oh, hundred.
That fruit means yeah. lots of things. So mm. if you tell me about finances, show me your millions.
Mm. Come on,
you know what I mean. But maybe his fruit is the wisdom that. Hey, don't spend money on this.
Because you
or maybe yeah. invest in that.
Yeah, that's or, right.
You know what I mean?
So hey, that's a word for me, man.
When you base it on fruit,
yeah.
we often think fruit means plentiful. So you need to have lots of fruit of that thing. But they have lots of knowledge. That's right. their fruit.
Yeah.
You know,
wow.
like sometimes fruit isn't necessarily practical things or the tangible things that you can touch.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. yeah.
Maybe fruit is also that, or also wisdom.
Yeah,
because
yeah.
a lot of things like kids our age, but like people, our generation and the
yes,
kids.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, yeah.
We often think that fruit isn't knowledge, because like knowledge isn't a great thing to us at this moment, because we want to see I want to see your fruits.
Right, mm. right.
But sometimes fruits is actually knowledge.
Yeah,
wisdom.
No, yeah.
I'm the same, eh? Like sometimes I feel like when people like give me advice,
yeah,
I'll be quick to just say, "Bro, who are you to tell me that?
Yeah.
Look at your life and look at this." But yeah. then you gotta look at it positively.
Yeah.
At end of the day, like as bad as their life could look, it's just like, bro, like they've learned from that, and they're trying to give it
yeah.
back to you.
Yeah, the wisdom. Yeah. yeah
but
yeah.
sometimes people can just be like, nah, I'm not listening to you. And I'm going to admit, like, there's times where I'm like that too.
Yeah, me too. Yeah. Oh, 100%.
Just quickly, sorry. You know how, so when I was speaking about elderly
yeah.
people, I wanted to ask you, Rolly, like, yeah. we'll ask you first. But do you, like, in our time, elderly people sometimes are perceived as, like, not relevant. Right. Or sometimes the advice that they give isn't as relevant to today's times. But, like, what are your thoughts on that? Like, do you think, in your experience, is elderly advice still relevant?
I think yes, 100%. And especially for us being islanders,
yeah,
and maybe if you're like me, you kind of didn't grow up in the homeland and you don't know much about your culture.
I think
culturally, 100% yes, the perspective and the advice of our elders is 100% relevant.
Yeah,
and yes, times are different, a lot different to when they grew up, but I think even regardless of that, they've lived a life. And they are way ahead in the journey than we are.
Yep.
And I mean, if you're like if you're one to just push aside advice from your elders, I think it's just ignorant, man.
Yeah.
Ignorant, like, you can never know too much. Yeah. You can never graduate from learning.
Yeah.
And bro, you're just upskilling at the end of the day. Like, more advice or more knowledge doesn't hurt anyone. And so,
yeah
man, I'd say, man, I am all for it. Really?
Yeah.
I'm all for it. And yeah, maybe if you're trying to seek advice and, you know, like in stuff that is relevant to this day and age, then yeah, maybe look elsewhere. But but I think for life in general, man, I think they've been through a lot more than we have.
Yeah. Well, they've got a lot more years.
A lot more years. I mean, some of them endured world wars.
Yeah.
Like, some of them have endured a lot.
Yeah.
They carry so much. They have so much gold. And if we would just take time out of our busy ass days.
Yeah, true.
Just to sit down and pick at that gold that they have. And like, they're willing to share it, man. And like, if you've ever been around elderly people,
yeah,
all they love to do is tell stories.
100%.
And out of all those stories, man, you get so much. And so if we're just willing to just listen and just be still for a second in our busy, busy world, then man, we would learn so much.
Yeah.
We would learn so much, eh? Yeah, but I'm heaps open to taking advice from elderly, especially if, you know, like, they're your grandparents.
Yeah. You have your grandma, eh, with you.
Yeah. So, nice. So it's just my grandma left. And she lives in New Zealand, so any chance, bro, I can get on the phone with her.
I love that, bro. Right,
we are on for hours, bro. You know how it is.
Nah,
hey,
I know.
Nana. It's, and then 2 hours.
Just say,
bro. But 2 hours worth it, bro. Nah,
how warm does that feel, eh? Like, just hearing your grandparents.
It's so good, eh? I don't know. It's one of those feelings, like, if you know, you know.
Yeah.
But sure. I'm glad that the bubble's open, bro, because I'm keen to... I need some physical interaction, man. I need to hug my nana.
If you don't know, if you're listening from overseas or somewhere not in Australia and New Zealand, Australia and New Zealand has approved a travel bubble during COVID, so we can travel from New Zealand and Australia back and forth.
Come on. Australia has a beautiful culture, by the way. Just want to say that.
For your question, my answer would be yes, but no. Okay, I'm going to go there.
Go there.
Can we go there? Can
yeah,
100%. All right. So I feel like there are, like, yes, I agree with what you're saying. And there's so much wisdom in our elderly people. But I'm going to touch base on the handful that are just going to, there's going to be some elderly people with good intentions, but their advice doesn't really align with the answer that you'd expect. Mm. Not because they're wrong, but sometimes it could be because of, like, the way they were brought up, or the times have just changed.
Yeah.
Out from the way they were raised, like, if back in the day.
Yeah.
And you know, I've heard this saying a lot, about saying, like, our generation is soft, has gone soft, or it's gone, you know, like, have you heard that? Have you heard that?
Yeah.
Kind of believe.
Yeah. So like the examples I could say was like, back then, working hard was praised, but and it still is sometimes to this day. But now, working smart is the new working hard, and you know, like, just you just hear, like, people saying, "Oh, back in my day, we used to work hard for our mullah and that and stuff like that. But
used to climb up the tree and down the mountain
and then swim the ocean etc. etc. And sometimes we don't really need to do that.
Yeah, that's it.
Sometimes we just gotta work smart and. But yeah, that's what I got from that. So maybe we can take their advice, but then we just pick and choose what's good for us.
Right.
And
it's like that potluck advice again.
Yeah, like you're taking
what you think is more relevant to you than not the whole thing, if anything.
Yeah.
It's funny that you say, like, when you're talking about with work easier, not harder, or do, you know, try to find something that maybe rewards the same, but you don't have to work as hard to get it.
Yeah, and that's
I remember sometimes it's not just a generational thing. Because I've spoken with guys my age, but a lot of the boys that I worked with are immigrants from other countries.
Wow.
Right, and I've spoken with them, and these boys are fine with pushing 70-hour weeks. Like it's nothing.
And then they're just like,
bro, you have to do something. Or they might work... like 40 is full time, right?
Yeah.
Full time hours.
Yeah.
And so I was pulling about 50, 60 hours with this job. And that was like, I was just like, far out, man. Yeah. This is a lot of work. And then these boys would probably do 60 hours there or 70. And then on their day off, we'll try to do something like drive taxi or drive an Uber. Mm. And it was just that, it's that immigrant mentality that some of our parents have and will try to tell us, hey, man, you need to go to work. Like, do this, do that, do this, do that. And everything will, you know, work out. And yeah, 100% I take advice as well.
Yeah.
But then there's also things that we see that we're like, oh, maybe we can change something. Or maybe we can, maybe I don't need to work all these hours to, you know, necessarily... you know, get ahead or provide, but also you also need to take into account our parents were supporting their own family with supporting family back in the islands. Like, it was a different day and age then as well. Like,
it was.
And sometimes they're still doing that. That's why it's advice comes from different people's context.
Right,
So sometimes with our context, it might be a bit different.
Yeah.
But... yeah, 100%. I see where you're coming from. You got to take advice, but also there's some advice that you're like, okay, maybe that's good advice, but it doesn't necessarily apply to me right now.
Yeah. I love that. Speaking of applying, whether the advice applies to you right now or not, I actually have this last question I wanted to bring to the table is, have you ever allowed your culture / upbringing to stop you from receiving a certain advice? And my experience is, and this is an example I've always had, and I honestly am still fighting with it today, is often at times, like, my Monday mornings, I love getting around, like, sermons and stuff that from the Sunday. And I often find myself, in a conflict between, like, I love the words that I'm hearing. I love the sermons that I'm listening to. One of the things I don't genuinely feel is a connection, as in he doesn't understand my story.
Right.
You know, like, I can't really 100% relate to a Caucasian man as much as I would to a African-American preacher.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying it's a race thing. I just think there's a different level of understanding of pain in a sense. Or just life experiences, you know. I'm more relatable to an African American preacher than I would be to a Caucasian preacher, and that's something I think I'm working on trying to you know, get around it, because there's so many like sermons I hear that are so and advices that I hear that are so, like, self fulfilling and all about self and a lot about, like, you know, improving stuff, yourself, right, self-improvement and stuff like that. But I'm more in tune, like, I'm more lenient towards stuff like thinking, what can I do for our people?
Oh, come on, bro.
You know, what about our people?
Yeah, that's good.
Not just
our context.
Because we grew up with a village mentality, village mindset, you know, like Frosty was saying last time, when I have, you have, when we have, when we don't have, we don't have. You know, and that's something I'm working on it, man. I'm working on it because sometimes when I hear someone giving me advice, like even just everyday life, if a Caucasian man was to come up to me and give me advice on something, I'm like, yeah, but you don't get like how we run our family. You don't get how things are done us. So it's hard for me to accept that.
It's a tale of two cities.
What are your guys' thoughts on that? So like, have you ever allowed your culture or, you know, experience, life experience, to stop you from getting advice? Or not stop you, but like, you found trouble in receiving advice?
Yeah, I remember I was, when I, early in kind of ministry and doing everything in church life,
yeah,
I was going to a different church from my parents and from my family. Some of the advice that I got was just like, just hang around, just be around the church, be around the house, serve, you know, because like God moves in this place, which, you know, I believe. But then it was to the point that when I started to be like, hey, I can't make it because, you know, it's my grandma's birthday, or I can't make it because I got family stuff. And then it was kind of like, bro, don't you want to see God move in your life? And it was kind of like, I was kind of like, you do not understand my context, because whether I fail or not, or whether I'm this hard out, you know, great preacher or not, like my family's there.
Come on,
100%.
You know what I mean? My brothers are there for me. My sister's there for me. Like, that's 100%. My family.
Yeah.
And or I don't know if you will be there for me.
No.
You know what I mean?
Come on.
So that's why I'm like, and when you've been in places that you've had no one, when you get advice from people like, this is all you need. What more do you need? Just be around this place, like, you know. And then it's like, oh, I don't, like, I've had people say, you know, there's a story in the Bible where this guy's, he goes to Jesus and he wants to follow Jesus. And he goes, oh, but give me a time to bury my father.
Because
he passed away. And Jesus says, let the dead bury the dead, right? So with me, I see that context like far out, you know, that's like serving Jesus is like, there's a toll to it. And it means like that. For me, I'm thinking that as a spiritual term, like, you know, don't dwell in that stuff. Like, you know, bury your father, but know that this is important. Know the standard of serving God is like that. There will be times that maybe you might not have, you know, might not be there, right? But then I've had people use that on me, like, hey man, like, let that happen. You know, let the dead bury the dead. But you got to come to church. You know, you got to.
Wow.
You know what I mean? And I'm like, no, I don't. Like, it's context and people that see certain scripture or see certain things in different ways.
Yeah.
And they don't understand. You know, if you can take it to real, real simpler terms, back when we were kids, it's when we first heard from, you know, certain people, your parents can't do that. Your parents can't hit you. Just tell your parents to shut up. Like, you know, and I was just, the first time you heard that from someone, you're like, what? Like, your parents aren't allowed to hit you. They can't touch you. And I was like, really?
and then they're at their house like, shut up, man.
Really? But I think that comes to that cultural background that we grew up with. There is, but 100%, I agree that we do we. You know, you do you, like, you know what I mean? As in our culture.
Yes.
Bring that to the table. Learn new ways, but but don't necessarily just say, nah, this is my culture. You don't understand. Block them off.
Yeah.
Because you can always learn from other people as well. And bring that stuff to your table, but flip the context. You know?
True.
Frank, bro, one of my experiences with culture and sort of upbringing sort of hindering me taking advice.
Yeah.
Growing up, had no idea what counseling was. Never heard of it. Wasn't a thing that existed.
Oh, bro.
Thing that existed. What the hell is counseling? I don't know.
What's red flag?
I don't know. Counseling is equivalent of like whatever my mom could pick up. Like,
just
Never laughs.
Bro, so then when I got a bit older, and then I got introduced to a counselor, and yeah, nah.
Who the fuck?
Just talk to me.
And then one was because of like what you were saying, Waves.
Yeah.
You don't know me. Yeah. You don't look like me.
100%.
You don't understand my context.
Yep.
How can I, one, open up to you, and two, take advice from you?
Yeah.
And I think even now, any sort of advice that I get from like a counselor or whatever, yeah, bro, I take it with a large grain of salt.
Yeah, bro.
It's just super hard because of our culture and our upbringing.
Yeah.
Like, one, I never knew what a counselor was. Like,
yeah.
And it was never explained to me why we needed one.
Yeah, bro.
Honestly,
yeah.
All of my family and all my ancestors have never seen a psychiatrist. Counselor. None of that. And so when we get introduced to this
stuff, do you know why I think it's so foreign to us, those kind of things? It's because we're so used to monologues. We're so used to just having us being told what to do.
Mm. Right.
Whereas we're never asked in our upbringing, or for me personally, we're never asked, I was never asked, how do you feel?
Right.
Yeah. Nah. It was never a dialogue. So I was like, what the heck is this? Like, I'm sharing my feelings. Stuff how you feel.
That's how I feel as a parent. What the heck are you doing?
Like, no. I hated lectures. Hey, yeah. I hated lectures. I'd rather get the hiding than the lecture. Because
that was me. Yeah,
that was a monologue.
You're more scarred from that, bro.
Nah, bro, but also, I love what you were saying.
Yeah.
It's not, this is my culture, stuff you.
Yeah.
Again, we can learn from other cultures. And so that was one thing that I loved about like a counselor is they always, they always give you an opportunity to share how you feel.
Yeah.
And to give you a chance to speak. And I think maybe in our culture we could learn.
There is some gun counselors out there that aren't Islander ones, but then some that aren't.
Aren't, right.
But they will they research and they know. And they'll be like, so the reason why you feel this is because your people group is from this and blah, blah, blah. And your ancestors and blah. And he's like,
wow.
Why are you picking me apart, mate? I didn't allow you to do that.
Yeah. Hey, bro, but I'm saying that, man, I would love to see a lot of our people become counselors.
In that field, eh?
Because, man, it would make life so much easier for our people who are going through this. And who have faced the struggles. Bro, when if you're a brought up Islander, that's all you do is listen.
My confusion when I saw, the first time I ever saw a movie, and someone was laying on a couch and just talking.
And then there was a guy
with a clipboard, and I was like, what's he doing? Yeah. And then the guy was a doctor, and I was like, there's a doctor? Like, he's a doctor? And I was like, what? He's not doing any examinations, physically. And he's like, talking and writing stuff down. And he's like, so I think, you know, maybe the reason why you're feeling this way is because of your childhood, blah, blah, blah. Yeah. And I'm like, is that a doctor? mind doctor. There's other doctors out there. There's a mind doctor.
It's like, wait, hold up. Does this guy get paid for that?
Bro, that's real, bro. But man, they could be listening right now, the future of our people to be doing counseling and that. So, man.
It could even be us, boys.
Ooh.
let's get the calls. Let's get the
How calls. Are you feeling?
I love that.
No. How are you really? How could you slap?
Nah, bro, that's awesome, bro.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much, boys. Ooh. I wanna end it off with just some thoughts that I wanted to share.
Ooh.
You know, with what we were talking about today, obviously with discerning voices and discerning advice, there's something that I heard. And it was actually funny. I was listening to it last night. I was listening to a song by 1-4, "Welcome to Prison."
Mm. Yeah,
and it was such a reality check for me because it's true. And YP in the beginning says these words. Free YP, by the way, yo. sorry. YP says these words. See, I grew up in church, but I had devils in my ears saying "effort." F it.
Yeah, we get it.
No, because it sounded like I said F it.
Oh, yeah.
See, I grew up in church, but I had devils in my ears saying F it, controlling my mind, my young mind, like a puppet. And the thought I had with that is, you know, there's so many voices in this world now. There's so many people trying to be loud in our young people's lives and even our own lives, our own personal lives. And something that I was really encouraged with the saying that I heard, and this is something I just want to leave and finish off this hot tala, is if God isn't speaking to you, then who is?
Right.
And that's something I really wanted to leave to encourage people. Like, let's take the time to hear from God. Let's take the time to allow, you know, good advice into our lives, and, you know, practice discerning, practice like sifting through what's good, what's God trying to say to me, what's God saying through that person or my brother or my mom or my dad or whoever's in your life now. You know, God can speak through those people to you. And that's such a good question I always want to ask myself is, if God isn't speaking to you, then who is?
Oh, great question. Great thought.
That's an awesome thought.
And that's
I love that song too.
That's the hot tala I wanted to finish off.
Well done.
Thank you.
Very good. Very
thanks for sharing.
Love
very
it.
Good.
And if you guys have any suggestions or things you want to comment on with what we're saying, make sure you comment down below or message us. We're definitely there for a chat. Rolling isn't because he never goes on the chat. Nah, we love you, Rolly.
Gonna see a counselor.
But thank you so much, boys. Thank you for the hot tala.
Great chat.
But right now, we're gonna get into our next segment, which is Bisupo.
The Usaw Table Talk Podcast.
I think it's Bosupo's fam. It's Bosupo's
fam. Oh my days, brother. What's that?
All right, Bisupo. So, what is Bisupo? Bisupo is where we talk about the good stuff.
The good stuff.
The goods.
Just like the pure stuff and the stuff that likes to just let us pour our hearts out and encourage one another. No? And just those that are out there, those that are listening right now. So listen up and listen quick.
Oh.
For... Nah.
What?
Okay, so I wanted to just... go back to a post that I posted just recently about this song called Heart of Worship.
Oh, nice. Us.
And I'm going to read the caption again. And it says, this song goes back to the late 90s where songwriter Matt Redman introduced his song to his worship team as the church congregation struggled to find meaning in its musical outpouring.
Mm.
And in response to that, the pastor of the church got rid of all the instruments and asked the team to just use their voices and sing. His reason behind this was that they lost their way in worship, and the way he believed to get back to the heart would be to strip everything away, all noises and distractions around.
Oof.
Reminding his church family to not just be consumers in worship, but being producers in worship also.
Oh, come on.
And so the lyrics, the first few lyrics says, when the music fades, all is stripped away and I simply come, longing just to bring something that's of worth that will bless your heart.
Mm.
Mm.
If you want to hear the rest, you can find it yourself. So what I'm trying to say here is that our problems may seem so hard to find or so hard to figure out in our lives, but when was the last time you actually just sat back and really spent time with yourself and all with God?
Yeah.
Our weeks can seem so busy that we can honestly like lose ourselves when we're living in our lives.
Right.
And I think it's just so important that you need to just have time for just you.
Mm.
Purely just you.
Yeah.
And we can be worked up in trying to find answers when the answers could just be sitting right in front of you. Like your family, your loved ones, your people, or your dreams, and even your goals.
Yeah.
So what I'm trying to say right now is just to encourage everyone to not hesitate to look at the simple things, because it could be the answer you're just looking for.
Come on.
Come on now.
So simple preach things, you know, get me.
Preachers.
Yeah, so yeah, big shout out to Eve for sharing that.
That's shout out, Eve.
Love you. Shout out.
She recently shared that video. I thought it was just a great reminder that the simple things can outmatch the most.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Come on, bro. That
big
was awesome.
Ups to you. And
good word.
So no, that was good.
Bro, needed that.
Looking good.
Reminder. Looking good. You gotta keep bringing that up. Oh, simple things, yeah.
Simple things. Looking good. Looking good. Well, that was beautiful, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for tuning in. Make sure you stay tuned. We got something in the end to surprise you with. But right now, we're gonna get those four nuns. He's gonna pray us out.
Let's pray.
Let's go.
Father God, we thank you for this this wonderful opportunity to just talk to our people and to encourage one another and to just bring unity in our people as well, Father. Mm. Oh God, I just pray for just the spirit of discernment to just be amongst this place and to just choose the right voices to listen to the right voices that are around us, Father. We thank you for who you are. Thank you for your love, and we pray for an awesome year. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
All right, fam. We have a big announcement to make. Big announcement, but very sad as well. We got our Uso Frosty, which is today is his last episode with us physically.
Yes.
But our Uso's moving to Gold Coast with his family.
Don't leave me.
Gonna be doing the most up there, making some noise up there as well. So yeah, bro. He's not leaving us.
He's not leaving.
He's not leaving us.
He's not
leaving the Uso Table Talk podcast.
He's never leaving us.
it's not a goodbye. It's a see you later.
It's a see you later.
See you soon. Yeah, I guess. So we've agreed that, well, I'm moving up Gold Coast, be with my family. And the Usos have been so kind to extend the helping hand that maybe I would continue some sort of interviews or podcasts or something. Bro. Still be a part of the Uso Table Talk. In some type of capacity, and just stay tuned and we'll see what the future holds. But I just want to thank you guys from the bottom of my heart, my Usos, my day ones, always being there for me, you know, and I appreciate yous. And man, how far we've come already.
Yeah,
with just, you know, I recently posted, you know, just some things and about, like, you know, how we stepped out of where we were originally, meeting on Bible college, and just thought, you know what, like, there's certain things that are happening outside of the four walls of church and of college that we need to address, and that we need to meet people where they're at, and also, you know, get back to reality. So it's been an honor to do this journey with you, Usos, and I can't wait to see where you boys will take it. And I don't know if there's going to be another member or whatever the plan is.
No.
And if there is, send your applications in. So, so, you know, we can get a fourth guy in with the boys for podcast episodes. But
guy,
you know,
girl. Or a girl.
Girl.
Or a girl, yeah.
Yeah, guy or girl.
Gal.
Female. Maybe a female.
No, but honestly, also, thank you so much for the time that you've spent with us. Even on and off the camera. Like, you know, you've been a true Uso. And I would like to honor you with something that we got for you. A little gift that we got for you, Uso. I didn't get time to wrap it. I wrapped it in my shirt. So, but this is a little gift.
You got a free shirt, too.
Oh, you got a free shirt.
Hey.
Wait, shout out.
Little photograph of,
I appreciate that,
of our team.
Let me get this.
Our fans.
Our fan, bro.
Oh wow, this is the fam.
Fambino.
Family.
You know what it is.
Oh wait, where's Winston?
He's there.
Oh, my dog's not here. No Winston.
Just anyway, put the insert in.
Of Kakele. Thank you so much, guys. Appreciate the journey.
It's been a ride, man.
It's been a long.
It's been a ride.
One hell of a ride.
What has been some of your favorite frosty moments?
Favorite frosty moments.
Yeah.
Ones that you can say on camera, bro. Just remember. Just remember we're recording.
I'll start. But honestly, my favorite frosty moments would have to be like the continuous arguments me and this guy has had. Honestly, it's one of those things only brothers can do that to me with. Say no. Because if it was anyone else, if it was just any random that I met, nah, stuffy, bro. I'm not doing it. But if anything, there was one moment that I really want to highlight is when the Uso Frosty really shaped this podcast in a sense of who we wanted to be for this podcast. And something, you know, for me, it was, I was trying to shake off, trying to come across as a faith, not a faith-based, but like as a podcast that had faith involved. And one of the things that Frosty really encouraged me was, you know, our faith is a big part of who we are.
Yeah.
So if we don't bring that from the get-go, then it's you know, not
just playing ourselves.
We're playing ourselves. So, and that was something I really take into my life as well. You know, we got to give people who we are.
Yeah.
You know, the world needs us, and that's something I'm really honored to have also, like also Frosty remind me of, and yeah, a bit of a, you know, little Frosty favorite there.
Similar to you, bro. Oh, I think I got two. One was, I think this would have been our first year, my first year of Bible college.
Yeah.
And we played a little NFL at the park.
Nah.
And then I don't know why, but I ended up going opposite this guy. And so like NFL, like you require it. So if you're on offense, you need a block. And
American football, if you,
And then so I was marking up against Frosty. And then I was trying to block him, and he put this move, and he freaking hit my nose and started bleeding. And I was like, oh,
wow.
You officially
brought us. What just happened? I was like, holy shit.
Shando.
Oh, my days.
Oh, man.
Yeah, so, yeah, but
mate, hold on. He's not innocent because he got me back when we were sparring. When he just ripped me in my ribs and I had to take a knee. So, hey.
Nah.
I'm not a bully, man. He got me back.
Iron sharpens iron.
Yeah. Well, he sharpened me, man.
Nah, bro. Gotta highlight the rocks, bro.
Oh, sorry, bro. I'm not done. I got one more.
Let's go.
And then, honestly, I think it's not like a moment, but rather it's something that you've been doing, bro. And you've just always been constant, man.
Yeah.
For us, but then even more so for me, bro. I was just this kid fresh out of high school from the area, had no idea what I was doing. Just trying to give this God dream a go, and I come to Bible college, I meet someone who looks like me. Yes.
Yes.
Who looks like me, sounds like me, and it's someone that I could relate to, bro. And you've been a huge, huge, and like we spoke about advice, you've been a huge, huge guiding voice for me, bro. Especially in my early years, early 100%. Teens. And yeah, bro, you're a vital part of why I was able to continue that journey, man. You and Morgs, but especially you, bro, and huge, huge thank you, man. You don't know how much of a vital role that you played at the time. And I don't think I've ever told you, bro, but I appreciate it, man. I appreciate it.
Appreciate you also.
Love you, bro.
Love you, man. Love you, bro.
Love you, man.
Anyway, we don't need to talk about the rocks, mate.
Just leave the rocks out of this.
Just leave the rocks out
if
of this.
If you know, you know.
If you can smell the rocks,
you know.
Say
it for me. Thank you, so.
Thanks, bro. Appreciate you guys, man.
But yeah, thank you so much, fam, for tuning in. Want to give a huge shout out to the Hills Podcast and Video Studio. Thank you for letting us use this space. Thank you for tuning in. And make sure you like and subscribe. Check out our socials, everything, all the links and all that stuff. We'll drop it down on the bottom for you. Make sure you comment, whatever. And we got some reactions coming soon, so make sure you stay tuned for that.
Stay tuned!
Check
your recommendations.
Also, a shout out to my fiance, Moana, I love you.
Shout out to my wife, Miss Morgan Renee Curly Frost, I love you. Shout out to my mother-in-law, Susan McNeil, I love you. Shout out to my mother, Seto Frost, I love you too.
We love you all.
Love you.
Shout out to my wife, Ricky Lee. Love you.
Wow. Oh, my knees, brother.
Jeez. What's going on, man? Dude, what just came out of my mouth?
Ricky Lee again.
Shout out to my footy team, Hack Boys. Go well today.
Let's go. Let's push.
Let's get the dub, boys. Let's get the dub.
Your game's on now.
Let's get the dub, boys.
That's why he's not playing, because it's here.
Say
that. What's up, boys?
Yeah, shout out to the Riff Boys, too.
Oh,
holding it down. Six games straight. Come on,
six and
baby.
Oh, baby.
Come on, 6-0.
Shout out to the Bulldogs. Let's they got go. A new signing. His name's Owen. Oh. Owen 6.
Oh, wow.
All right, we love you guys.
Oh, when was the last time?
Hey, don't ever talk about my doggies like that again, all right?
Up the doggies!
Okay. Doggies!
Love yous. Thank you.
We love yous.
Mad love.